phrase like this.
Okay, this. I can try.
Very small.
But where should I? Should I put it around the hole?
Around.
Everywhere.
Yeah, around the hole. Like, yes.
I am Magnus Jonsson at Linköping University. I'm a senior lecturer there, and I'm leading the organic photonics and nanooptics group at the Laboratory of Organic Electronics. And in my team, we are studying how light interacts with nanostructures, and then we combine those type of fascinating effects with other types of materials and concepts, such as in this device here, where we combine light-induced heating in a nanoplasmonic surface, in a nano-optical surface, with thermoelectric and pyroelectric effects, which makes it possible for us to make new types of sensors. So in this type of device, we make a sensor that can detect both light illumination, solar illumination, and also heat at the same time. So it's possible for this device to detect light and heat very rapidly, and also to get stable signals for long times. And that is a big improvement compared to previous concepts where you could either measure very rapidly, but then not have a signal for during long times, or we could have signals after long times, but the signal would come very, very slowly, so it would take long time to detect the light or heat. So these type of devices illustrate some of our research that is quite applied. We start at the fundamental level to understand what's happening, but the intention with these type of devices is to make new sensors that can be useful in different applications, such as for electronic skin, for example, that needs to be able to detect both heat from the body and also illumination from the sun. And that's based on this combined device that you made.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So this device can take advantage of both the pyroelectric effect and the thermoelectric effect from the thermionic gel. And then we use plastic.